An Israeli Air Force jet downed a suspicious aerial object late Monday night as it was heading to Israel's southern city of Eilat from the direction of the Red Sea. The aerial object was most likely sent by Yemen's Houthi terrorists, whose military spokesman, Yahya Sari, claimed the operation was a success without divulging more information.
The Yemeni armed forces, alongside the Iraqi Islamic Resistance, carried out a joint military operation targeting a vital target in Umm al-Rashrash, south of occupied Palestine, with a number of drones.
This latest incident comes after last week's attack launched by the group on a ship traveling through the same area, only the most recent in a series of targets in this crucial maritime route. Adding further fuel to the fire, the Houthis, who claim that the US and Saudi Arabia sought to economically destroy Houthi-controlled Yemen after failing militarily, released aerial footage of key ports and airports in Saudi Arabia, aiming to remind them that they are still capable of striking deep inside the kingdom. Since November, the Iranian-backed Houthis have been launching drone and missile strikes in shipping lanes in what the group claims is solidarity with Palestinians in Gaza.
The Yemeni armed forces will persist to carry out their joint military operation with the Iraq Islamic Resistance in support of and solidarity with the Palestinian people until the aggression stops and the siege on the Palestinian people in the Gaza Strip is lifted.
In an effort to discourage more attacks, the U.S.-British naval coalition stationed in the region has conducted air raids and missile strikes against Houthi targets. Meanwhile, in an effort to push the Yemen peace plan forward, a Chinese diplomat announced that Beijing, along with the UN Special Envoy for Yemen, five permanent UN Security Council members, and other key parties, would begin working together.
We must ensure the Red Sea security and make our position clear to the Houthis and other parties. The Red Sea crisis has lasted nearly 6 months, causing significant losses. We call for an end to these attacks.
He added that China would be closely monitoring the Red Sea situation, but urged an end to attacks on commercial vessels to avoid disrupting global supply chains.